Hey guys, in this video, we're gonna tie a trucker's hitch and we're gonna put an anchor on that end. We're gonna use a round turn with two half hitches and we're going to establish our high line or our ridge line. As a certified animal packer and former Marine Corps mountaineer, I know the value of a good knot. I'm Norseman and this is What Not to Do. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do is pick two trees that are far enough apart for you to set up your shelter and everything. And you're gonna want them to be fairly large size trees. This is probably the minimum that I would go, because as the wind blows, the trees are gonna sway and it's gonna tighten and slack my line. And I want my line as tight as possible, so I would probably pick a larger diameter tree, something that's not gonna sway so much in the trunk. But irregardless, let's tie a high line. So the first part of the system that we're gonna tie is the round turn and two half hitches. That's gonna be our anchor. So I go around and around again, so that's the round turn. And then two half hitches. I'm gonna come over and up the middle and then the same direction, back up and through. And I know I did it correctly because I'm actually gonna end up with a clove hitch on that line. That's my two half hitches. That is gonna be my anchor. I can dress everything up nice and tight. There's other anchors you can tie. You can put a bowline on this. You can put a timber hitch on this or various other types of anchors that you wanna do. But a round turn or two half hitches is the easiest to tie. It takes up very little rope and it's super easy to get undone when you wanna take the system down. Your next step is going to be to bring the line over to your second tree. Next, you'll select a section a good distance from the end, because you are going to take up some slack, but not so far in that you're going to interfere with where you want to set your shelter. So I like to go at least one arm's distance off the back of the tree. That's usually plenty and it gives me lots of room to set up my shelter and I can draw most of this tension in. If you don't know what I'm talking about, you'll understand in just a second. So I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna make a little bite in the rope right here. And I'm gonna go one, two, and then I'm gonna bring this rope, this end, not the anchored end, the running end or the working end through, and I'm gonna have a figure eight and a bite. So we're gonna try that again. There's my anchor. Back here's my working end. I'm gonna hold this little loop. One, two, and you can go more than two if you want, but two's usually sufficient. I'm gonna pass this working end through and make a loop. I'm sorry, make a bite. Now that I have that bite, I have basically a figure eight with a bite. With that figure eight with a bite, here's my direction of pull. So make sure I have enough. I'm gonna take this working end and go around the tree, and I'm just gonna pull the tag end through. Kind of a long rope, but I'll pull it through. I can hold that there against the tree, and that friction's gonna help hold it. And then I pinch right here at the bend. After I pinch that, I go over and I basically do, it's a half hitch on a bite. So I'll pull this tight, I'll get it as tight as I can. There's my mechanical advantage system. I'm gonna pinch right here, take a bite and go over and back up through this space. Once I pull that tight, it'll hold on that bite. So now I've sort of lined these two trees up so I can pull on the other end, and I wanna just show you how dramatic of a mechanical advantage system you can get pulling on this small tree stump. So now I've managed to put that much tension on that tree stump and tie it off securely. That's going to be taut enough for almost any shelter you would need to build. It's easy to retension if it gets loose through the night, and when your trip is over, super easy to recover. Once you pull this line out, This knot pulls out nice and simple. And now, even after all of that tension, the anchor is super easy to untie. You can pack up your rope and head home. So go out, experiment with this high line or this ridge line system if you want. Be cautious. Depending on the line that you use, with this I can pull as hard as I can and I'm not gonna break the line. But when you're using 550 cord or natural twine or something like that, it's very, very easy to exert too much mechanical advantage and actually snap the line. So get it as tight as it needs to be, but don't be over greedy with the tautness of the line. You can always go back and tighten it up later if it needs a little bit more tension. If you ever need to lock this line so that pulling this doesn't just pop it, like in the case if this was a high line and I was actually tying up horses or mules to this line, I wouldn't want them to be able to get bored and chew on this rope and pull it through and release the line. That would be a bad thing. In camp, maybe I'm concerned about dogs or kids or something pulling on it. All I have to do is put one half hitch, two half hitch on that line, and it is now locked. Doesn't matter how hard you pull on this, it's not going anywhere. Essentially, I just put a clove hitch, an over the object clove hitch on the end of that line. I hate to teach and run, but it looks like I have rain coming in on me and I need to get my shelter set up in very short order. So go out, practice that system. Get very quick and proficient at it. And I'll see you on the trail.